In Manatee County, a culture of business and community are starting to pull together. Good morning. I'm Dwayne Lindo, in for Dr. Ed James, and this is Black Almanac. A local organization in existence for more than a year is growing in numbers. With us today, the Manatee Black Chamber of Commerce and their plans for the community. Joining us, President and CEO Tarnisha Clyatt, Vice President of Marketing Michelle Grimsley, and Marketing Executive Simone Peterson. Well, the last time the Manatee Black Chamber of Commerce was here was about March. Fast forward 6-7 months later to present day, you guys have grown exponentially, needless to say, which is a good thing.
Absolutely.
Am I right?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Definitely.
Making sure. Now, the point of the Manatee Black Chamber of Commerce is to champion small minority business in Manatee County. Tarnisha, I want to start off with you. Let's refresh some of the viewers' memory. What was the main reason you started this particular organization?
Well, there was a need of for the chamber due to the fact of collaborating with small businesses and trying to grow. At the time, I'm Mary Kay business, and just trying to just connect with different people that look like me. And there was a missing segment of that, so we had to create what we didn't have.
Mm-hmm. Now, like I mentioned before, the last time you was here was in March. Michelle was here as well. It was about a year when you started, because you guys started back in March of 2015, I believe. And it was your year anniversary the last time you was here. Again, you've been around for a year and a half. Tell me, how much have you grown since the time you guys kind of opened your doors, if you will?
Well, we started out at the time with none, with no members, and we've grown to about 100 members now. So that in itself, we have definitely made tremendous gains. Along with, we have a lot of great events that we've partnered with, and I think that's something to be proud about.
Mm-hmm. Now, again, the overall goal of this particular organization is to champion small business. Michelle, what have you guys done in terms of trying to get businesses into this organization?
Sure. We actually go out and seek businesses. Our president does business walks, and she goes and visits businesses in the community just to find out what their needs may be. We don't know unless we go out and solicit for ourselves. So we actually go out and solicit companies. Word of mouth is huge. I mean, we all know that that's the best way to advertise. So word of mouth, we're very big on social media. So we advertise the chamber, advertise what the chamber can offer different businesses, and we go straight to the person in charge and ask them simply, will you join us so that we can help you be successful?
Mm-hmm. Now, speaking of advertising, obviously Vice President of Marketing, that's your position. And Simone, you're a marketing executive. So if you can kind of just give me, brief me, you know, what you do, and you're relatively new to this organization, am I correct?
Correct. Basically, as a marketing executive, I help with developing of advertising or advertisements, marketing materials, flyers, and I help try and promote on the side as well different events that are happening. One of the major initiatives we've had in the past few months is the different forums and debates we've had, and they've been really successful. And the last one we just had, it was a packed house. And it goes, one might think, well, what does voting have to do with business? But it directly ties in, because you want to make sure that your elected officials are all about small business as well.
Mm-hmm. Now, I got to say that prior to you guys coming on the scene, normally you don't necessarily see minority businesses out front and in the open. But since you guys have been here, I mean, you see kind of who's out there in terms of minority businesses. They have kind of a voice, if you will, to kind of get them out in the open, making sure that people, it doesn't matter what race you are, but people out in the community know who they are. So if you can kind of give me a sense of what businesses have you done business with?
We actually have done business with Wingstop, and that's one testimonial that I think is very vivid in my mind. As it relates to Wingstop, they're located on First Street in Bradenton, and so many times people pass by until we host an event there. We hear people say, I never even knew that this place even exists. And for that to say, that speaks volume to us. We're bringing that recognition to them. And we're also proud to announce that it's owned by an African American. And so those are the type of testimonials we hear. And I think that's something that is definitely a test to why we need it to be in existence.
Now, speaking of businesses, one thing that businesses create is jobs. Now, one thing you guys have done, and I know you guys have done it multiple times, job fairs. Mm-hmm. So, Michelle, I'll defer to you. Tell me how you come up with putting these job fairs together.
Sure. Well, it all comes from an idea birthed from our president, and we all get together and we make that happen. We see that there's a need for opportunities within our community, so we get together, roundtable discussion, what industries do we think we need representation in, and just start to simply work. Contact people in those industries, contact different businesses, contact a location so that we can host the job fair, and just make it happen. I mean, it takes a very diligent effort, but we have a very strong team, so that's why we've been so successful with our job fairs.
Mm-hmm. And speaking of successful, I'd like to get, or and the viewers would like to know, kind of what, I mean, not specific numbers, but give me a sense of, you know, how many folks, since you've been doing these job fairs, how many folks have been hired in Manatee County? Kind of, you know, well, how many businesses altogether do you have at these job fairs? One. Two, how many folks have been hired due to these job fairs being put out in the open?
We had about, at our last job fair, about 30 employers that were there, and I think of roughly about 15 people that had on-the-job, on-the-spot interviews. We know of three or four people that had some entry-level positions that were obtained, along with executive positions that were obtained. We partnered with USF, and a student from USF came over, and he was offered a job on-the-spot at Microsoft, and I think that's what job fairs are all about, having the opportunity to bring the job fair or the employer to the place where the employee can then have the opportunity to bid for a job.
I know, and you mentioned the University of South Florida. I know there was an SBA workshop there as well, the University of South Florida, Sarasota Manatee campus. That's one thing I wanted you and you guys to talk about. Tell me how that came about.
Well, we actually, we're really big on partnership, and that's one of our main words that we talk about within our inner circle. We have keywords that we chime in on, and collaboration is one of those words. And we try to collaborate with all entities within our community. And so happened, we went out to USF, and it's all about, I believe, you never know if that person's going to participate until you ask. So we went out and we asked, and we got the yes, and that's what we're excited about.
Okay. Now, Simone, in terms of collaborations, I mean, what does collaborations in the community mean to the average everyday folk that lives in Manatee County?
Well, when it comes to collaboration and partnerships, no one has the end all be all. They don't have the one solution. They have part of the solution. So with collaborations in the community, especially when company A and company B or nonprofit A can put in their resources, it makes a very vibrant community. And then for the person in that community, there's a lot of resources that they can really apply for and things that they can really strive for and be a part of. So I think it's just collaboration nowadays, especially with shrinking budgets and resources. That's the name of the game. That's how you do business nowadays. Mm-hmm.
And I know I'm putting you guys on the spot here, but, and this is something I wanted to possibly ask later on in the show, but, you know, what's happening in the future. But in terms of job fairs, is there any job fairs coming up in the future? I know you have it, I'm not sure, quarterly or possibly every half year, or is there a specific time frame where you usually have job fairs?
We do have them every about 6 months, so on a twice a year. We do have one that we're teaming up now. We're looking into getting the nuts and the bolts together for that. We already have the template. We just have to start with the date. So we do have that in motion.
Mm-hmm. Now, one thing I've noticed, and I've heard quite a few people in the community that are proud of this community kind of achievement awards banquet, that you kind of recognize some of the folks that are contributing to the community, obviously specifically in Manatee County. And I happen to be a part of that, but kind of give me a sense of how that came about and what it's all about and who you recognize.
2016, we had our gala, and it was centered around the community. We had a small business achievement award. We had large business. We had corporation, along with a non-for-profit. We also had a small individual membership of the year, along with a couple others. I think it was the sorority and fraternity. We also had the Doctor of the Year, right, as well. So we just tried to reach as many avenues of the business sector as possible. And that's how we reached out to the individuals. And we had a voting system where you were able to nominate those individuals. And we just came back with the ones that had the highest numbers to be awarded during that time.
Mm-hmm. And are we planning on... I'm hoping we're planning, but we're planning on having the next one, the next year's achievement, you know, gala, if you will. I mean, yes, no?
Yeah.
I'm putting you on the spot here.
No, yeah. Absolutely. If you've already saw our social media page and our website, we've already began to announce that we are accepting nominations. So please feel free to go out there and nominate anyone that you've deemed necessary to represent those categories. So we're definitely starting, and we will have another gala this year, 2017. We'll have our gracious hosts again. Thank you very much for accepting. I know you've already felt the need to do so.
Yeah. And prior to this gala, one thing I was, I had a lot of fun at was the fashion show. There were artists from all over the country.
Absolutely.
I mean, there was artists from all over the world.
Absolutely.
Tell me what that's all about, and the story, the kind of the back scene story of that was pretty impressive, how that came about. And I want you to tell that story here on Black Almanac.
Well, it all started with the vision of wanting to showcase our community with the fashion. We all know that we have a fashion-forward community. And so we just started there. We took the idea of having artists or designers come together and to be able to showcase their work on display. And so we reached out to a different a fashion producer, and he took it from the one level to the next level, and that's where it went. And I know everyone's expecting a higher time this year.
Mm-hmm. Now, changing gears here, but Simone, I'll ask you this. I know one of the main purposes for the Manatee Black Chamber of Commerce is to get the community out to know who they're voting for. So basically, school board races, county commission races, city council races, that's very important in the community. Obviously, when you're voting on the federal level, it's important, but I think it's important for folks to know what's going on at the local level too. And I think,
absolutely,
if anything, that's even more important than, mm-hmm, what's going on the federal level, even though that's important as well. Let's not get it twisted. Question for you. Why does the Manatee Black Chamber of Commerce invite persons that are running for office to debate?
Well, it goes back again to getting people to understand. If you go out on any kind of Manatee County street, you can ask someone who's running for president. They'll know right off the bat. If you ask them who's running for your city council or your county commission, they have no clue. And many times they don't know who's representing them now. So by having those people who are running for a candidate office go to our debates and matching up those same people to say, hey, these are the people that are running to represent you. Listen to their campaigns, listen to what they're saying. If you like their platform, please go vote for them. If not, seek out another candidate, do some research yourself. You have to do research, you have to be educated, because these people are the ones that's gonna be representing you. And if they're not your candidate, then be sure to, you know, go out there and research. That's the biggest thing that I've come to notice. We had our watch night party for the primaries, And at our location, there was a couple of people who walked in, and they didn't even know that they had a voting day, that the primaries are happening that day. I'm like, how do you not know that simple information that you should be exercising your right to vote? And that's just very disheartening. It really is.
And Tardisha, I'm going to assume that you basically agree. I mean, making sure that folks know what's going on in the local level is paramount, and that's the reason why you have these types of debates in the community.
It's clear that we have to have this. It's a charge that we have to do. We take that seriously because we know that the dollars that are filtered into our community are definitely being outsourced and streamlined from those county commissioners or city council members. So therefore, we have to know who we are and who are representing us. So therefore, we have to do our due diligence in representing and making sure that these people are representing what we feel is the best for our community. And I know Simone said this, it was disheartening to see only 20% or less than 20% got out to vote for the primary election. We have to do a better job as a community. If we want change, we have to be the change that it takes to make it a better place. And that's one thing that we're going to stick to. We're going to continue to do the debates. We're going to continue to educate our community.
And most recently, the Manatee County District 1 school board race, Edward Viltz versus Gina Messenger. I mean, they're going head to head. Manatee County District 3, the school board race, David Watchdog Minor against Misty Servia, and the Brayton City Council race, Ward 5. That was the debate happened, I believe it was last week. Everyone here attended the debate. Michelle, I'll defer to you. How important was that debate? Right in the heart of the city of Bradenton, how important was it to have that particular debate? Obviously, elections coming up in a week and a half.
I can't express how important it was to have that debate. We were able to bring information to our community and to people that maybe work during times that other events are held or work during times that they might be able to meet up with those candidates. And those candidates, that was their very last opportunity before the election to get their word out. So we had a lot of people actually come, and it was a packed house, as Simone said earlier, but it was so important because, you know, even myself, I try to keep on top of these kinds of things, but I learned a few things at our debate that I didn't know prior to that. So, you know, I may have been skewed one way versus the other. If I hadn't attended, I wouldn't have found out those things. So I can't tell you how important it is to be able to have brought that event to our community.
And how did this come about? I mean, did you talk to the candidates themselves to see if they wanted to debate, or how did that come about?
Again, the marketing team does a fabulous job with our events. We put it at the forefront of the marketing team. They then went out and researched to see who would be good candidates for that particular debate. From there, I know they send out a process of inviting those individuals to come out. They either accepted or declined, and then that brought them to that Thursday.
Right, mm-hmm. Right. Now, I know going to the minority businesses, Vern Buchanan was able to speak to quite a few business owners in the community, and I know that's something you guys will do too. We'll bring folks who have made it in business. Vern Buchanan is a good example, congressman now. How did you get Vern Buchanan to come talk to these folks?
Well, again, we find it very important to seek those individuals that may hold, like you said, a title position. And we definitely understand the fact that if you have that representation, if you hold that power, we need you to come back and speak to us because you represent us. So we sent out an invite, and we invited him to come for a roundtable discussion to allow us to hear how he was able to make it in that community or the community of small business. And he, for one, is definitely a champion in that position. So he was able to provide some pros and cons of small business 101 minority or entrepreneurship. And from there, I think we had some very good discussion there, and I think everyone left there with some good nuggets to move forward. And those are the kinds of things that we offer to our members, to have those roundtable discussions with key individuals that can take them to the next level is really important.
Yeah, I know. I also attended that meeting, and Vern Buchanan, literally, he had to just jet out of there because folks kind of was basically asking him questions left and right, and he couldn't leave,
yeah.
Which was a good thing. It was a great thing. Now, I want to get into networking events, basically the future of Manatee Black Chamber of Commerce. What type of networking events, other than what we mentioned, have you done in the past, and what do you plan on doing in the future in terms of networking?
In terms of networking, what we've done previously, we've tried to be eclectic about how we do networking, because you hear about many socials where you just show up to a place and you exchange business cards. We want to do something differently, and what we've done in the past was like a paint night. If you ever heard of Painting with a Twist or businesses similar to that, we've had nights like that where it's like, come in, paint, talk with your neighbors, socialize. I know for December, we're going to have our Jingle and Mingle networking event where basically we come together as a family, as a Manatee County Black Chamber of Commerce family, invite friends, but also it'll also double as a toy drive. So bring a toy, mingle, socialize, things like that. But the networking is really important because I know for me being new into this organization, I did not realize how many minority-owned businesses that we had here. I'm like, okay, great, because I mean, when you want to invest in your community, you want to shop local. And when you shop local, I mean, I want to, you know, patronize people who look like me. And I'm like, I want you guys to succeed. I want you to prosper. And so to know that there's so many black businesses out there, it's great to know.
All right. Now, the election watch party, I mean, that in and of itself, I would think, would be kind of a networking event. Am I right, Michelle?
Absolutely.
And I know, you know, I know Simone kind of alluded to the watch party, but I kind of want to know more about that.
Sure. Any event that the Manatee County Black Chamber of Commerce hosts is a networking opportunity. And for our election watch party, it's, as it says, an election watch party. We're going to go to the venue. The TVs will have county elections, state elections, the federal elections, and we're going to watch the numbers roll in. We're just going to be paying attention to the polls. But with that, we're going to be networking with the other individuals that are there, because as we see who is going to now represent us, we might need to dialogue about how we need to now move forward and take what is our next step going to be. So we will be sitting and watching TV for the most part, but as we find out who is going to represent us, we'll then be able to dialogue about what our next step will be.
Okay. And any other networking events, Tarnisha, that are coming in the future, something that you need to get out in the open?
Well, we do have several events that are coming up for 2017. We have our Youth Entrepreneurs Workshop, where we'll host that at the Manatee Elementary School. And we'll have 25 youth that will be able to participate with us. We will open up bank accounts for these youth, and we will the entire day have you there to help us out to go
put me on the spot.
Go from discussion to discussion, from class to class, in hour increments of time to learn about entrepreneurship and to build their own businesses. So we're really excited about that. We also have a collaboration of with Microsoft there. We'll also have Wells Fargo. We'll have the Manatee County government that'll participate with us. So we're really excited about that. We also have our board party that will kind of plan out our entire year. And we call that the, what is it, Michelle? I'm sorry.
Executive Board Member Retreat.
Our Executive Board Member Retreat, but we also will have a place where we can plan as far as our members can come back in and they can plan their whole year out as well with us. The Vision
Board
Party, that's
right.
What it is. Thank you. Mm-hmm. I was stretching that. We also have our gala that's coming up in March. We'll kick it off with our golf tournament, and we're really excited about that. We'll also have our fashion show again, and we'll also have our gala that will showcase our community members that will be honored during that time. And we also have a little twist on some things, too, but we'll let that last for a little bit later.
Okay. And we'll probably mention that in the next minute or so. But for the folks, because I know you have quite a few events coming up, mm-hmm. but for the folks who want to go to any of these events, you mentioned Facebook, but what other social media or websites can folks visit to find out specifically what events you have going on?
We're at www.manateeblackchamber.org. That's www.manateeblackchamber.org. We are also on Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, as well as Instagram.
Right. So, I mean, you're all over the place. And, you know, we'll make sure that, you know, the folks see, you know, actually a full screen, you know, what's going on there. But one thing I've asked you the last time you were here, and I want to ask this again, for all these events you have going on, obviously the folks in Manatee County, they have access to what you have going on. But what about outside of Manatee County?
I'm glad you asked that question. Great question. We don't only host or have the Manatee County community come to our events. We have people from across the greater Tampa Bay area, and that's something that is, I think, is special. Our name is definitely a household name in the greater Tampa Bay area. We have people that travel from Lakeland. We have people that travel from Orlando Lakes. We have people traveling from Tampa, Sarasota. We're really excited. Fort Myers as well. So we have reached a great distance of the greater Tampa Bay area. And with that being said, 2017, we will market to the Manasota brand. So we'll be leaving Manatee and channeling into the Manasota Black Chamber of Commerce.
Mm-hmm. Now, I know you wanted to kind of mention a few other things that were going on. So briefly, kind of mention what you wanted to mention before.
Well, the key thing was we will be kicking off our Manasota brand. That is Manasota Black Chamber of Commerce. So we now have the opportunity to do business in Manatee and Sarasota communities. We're really excited about that. With our wonderful marketing team, our whole emblem and logo will change. Our name will change, but we'll still service the same, and we'll still have the spirit of excellence to our community. Okay. So we're really excited about that.
Yeah. Now, Simone, briefly, to end the show, I'd like to get a sense of, now that we have out in the open that we're expanding here, what are the tools that the marketing team has to do to get this done?
It's going to be happening in the next few months, press kits, rebranding, all that good stuff. But I will say that, to echo Tarnisha on, while we have a lot of stuff to do in the background, look forward to 2017, because this is just the groundwork we're laying. Next year is going to be phenomenal. Different level, different expectations, and just look forward to it. And if you're not on board now, get on board so we can take you there.
Miss mm-hmm. Peterson, Miss Grimsley, Miss Clyde, I thank you for joining us. Have a great day, Suncoast.
Thank you.
There was this big bruise on my friend's face. I didn't want to see it. I didn't want to think her own nephew could have hit her.
I didn't want to see it. My mother's bank account was emptied, and her caregiver had taken control of it.
I didn't want to see it. My father's refrigerator. There was hardly anything in it. That's unusual for him.
It's tough to see that a senior citizen is being abused, physically, emotionally, sexually, or financially. Elder abuse is a crime.
So see the signs. Stop the crimes.
The official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC7. We're here for you.